The diesel world has a lot of different designs and features and way of doing things as compared to the world of gas, trucks, and cars. And we've gone over some of those different designs and ways of doing things in other videos. And while we're making those videos, I noticed one thing, and that's that the newer Duramax trucks have a really funny looking exhaust tip. And that got me thinking, why does it look like that? Is it for emissions? Is it for, you know, cooling? Is it for production costs? Like, why is GM putting this funny looking exhaust tip on their trucks? So sit back, get your popcorn, and get comfy, because today I'm going to tell you exactly why GM uses that funny looking exhaust tip on their Duramax trucks. So getting right to the point, this system is actually used for one simple reason, and that's exhaust heat. Now you might be wondering, exhaust heat, why is that an issue? Exhaust heat, like exhaust temperatures coming out of the exhaust tip, are not that hot. Like, you can go up to a running car and have your hand a couple inches away from the exhaust and it's really not that hot, especially at idle. But you have to remember that modern diesel trucks have some emission systems on them, and those emission systems create heat. More specifically, modern diesel trucks have a diesel particulate filter. The diesel particulate filter, also known as a DPF, itself isn't what causes those crazy exhaust gas temperatures, but rather how the DPF is cleaned. We've covered this in other videos, but for those who don't already know, let me explain what the diesel particulate filter is and how it works. The job of the DPF is simple: capture excessive exhaust soot and then burn it off occasionally through a regeneration mode. It does the regeneration through two modes: an active regeneration mode and a passive regeneration mode. Passive regeneration occurs when the exhaust temperatures are naturally high enough to oxidize the soot collected in the DPF faster than the soot is collected. This typically occurs when the temperature of the DPF is above 300 degrees Celsius or 572 degrees Fahrenheit. And that typically occurs during highway driving or when driving with heavy loads. Since passive regeneration occurs naturally, it is considered to be a normal part of engine operation. Active regeneration occurs when the exhaust temperatures are not naturally high enough to oxidize the soot collected in the DPF faster than it is collected. This works by injecting a small amount of diesel fuel into the exhaust stream, which is then oxidized by the diesel oxidation catalyst. It injects the fuel into the exhaust stream using the late injection method, which is simply firing the injectors late into the exhaust stroke, or by using the ninth injector method, which is an injector mounted directly to the exhaust system. In the case of modern Duramax diesels, such as the LML and the L5P, they use the ninth injector method for their active regeneration mode. The oxidation of this additional fuel raises exhaust gas temperatures to approximately 550 degrees Celsius or 1022 degrees Fahrenheit, which is needed to regenerate the DPF. And that's where the issues lie, with the active regeneration and how hot the exhaust has to get in order for it to work. Say, for example, you are driving your Duramax truck, or any truck for that matter, and you were sitting in traffic on the highway. You got cars all around you and your truck flips over into active regeneration. So now there's 1000 degree exhaust gas coming out of the tip of your truck. The car to your right side and kind of towards the rear of the truck, it's gonna be getting blasted by your 1000 degree exhaust gas temperature, and that can easily destroy their paint, melt their bumpers, catch stuff on fire, and so on. Or, for example, your truck was in active regeneration and you were working around the truck and you had to walk around the backside of it, and that exhaust gas literally just burns your leg, and that would be a pretty nasty burn, send you to the hospital. Or, for example, if you worked in forestry, or you were in the forest doing some sort of work, or you were in the desert doing some sort of work and there was some brush near your truck, specifically near the tailpipe of your truck, 1000 degree exhaust coming out of the tip can very easily set some brush on fire. And obviously, setting the forest on fire is really not ideal unless you're some sort of arsonist that lives in California. Regardless, the point is that exhaust gas coming out of the tip of your truck during active regeneration is crazy hot and can very easily catch things on fire or damage vehicles or damage people or worse. So, with that problem in mind, what's the solution? You really don't want to add more stuff to the exhaust. You already have a diesel particulate filter, the ninth injector, diesel exhaust fluid injection, and so on. So how do you cool down a really hot exhaust before it exits the tip? And the answer is actually really simple. mix it with cool air before it exits the tailpipe. And that's exactly what GM is doing with this exhaust tip. By having those vents prior to the tip, they're able to create a venturi effect. It's at this point that I'd like to point out that it's not just GM that does this. You'll actually find venturi exhaust tips on all sorts of applications, from Ford Powerstroke trucks, Audi cars, and more. Although, for example, on the Ford Powerstroke trucks, it's definitely a more discreet style. To explain this system really simply, as the exhaust gas flows past the vents, it pulls in cold air from outside the exhaust system, which then mixes in that short section before the real tip, and then that cooled exhaust gas exits the system. There are also potential performance benefits with this system, as it can actually help pull exhaust gas out of the system, which reduces back pressure, but the performance benefits are pretty minor and certainly not the main focal point for this design. That being said, you can just totally ditch this system. There's plenty of Duramax trucks out there with aftermarket exhaust tips and everything works just fine. There's really nothing that'll happen to your truck by getting rid of this tip in favor of a more traditional style tip, other than the fact that there will be a noticeable and measurable difference in the exhaust gas temperature exiting the tip. Now, if you don't particularly care about how hot your exhaust gas is exiting the tip, there's really no reason to keep this system around, especially for you guys that have deleted diesel trucks, so you have no DPF filter, so you have no regeneration mode. There's really functionally no benefit to having this type of exhaust tip, and there's really no reason to keep it around. I think it's also worth noting that you'll find this type of exhaust tip on commercial applications like semi-trucks, not all semi-trucks, but some of them, because they have to deal with similar strict emission standards like our, our Powerstroke, our Cummins, our Duramax trucks. They have to deal with really strict emission standards, and so do those commercial semi-trucks. They're also dealing with insane emission standards, so they have similar things, such as a diesel particulate filter. Because of that, they also have that active regeneration mode, so they deal with the same issue. I hope you guys enjoyed this short video explaining why GM uses these funky looking exhaust tips on their Duramax trucks and why it's also used on other applications. And to briefly sum it up, it's basically for the venturi effect, which then allows the exhaust gas to be cooled before it exits the tip. And the whole reason it's doing that is because during active regeneration, to clear out the DPF, exhaust gas is upwards of 1000 degrees Fahrenheit, and that needs to be cooled before it leaves the truck, or it can very easily catch things on fire. In fact, we mentioned this in another video, but there was that viral video a long time ago of a Ford Powerstroke going into regeneration mode or active regeneration mode, and it had a literal flame coming out of the system. It's pretty funny. You really don't see that anymore. It's not something that really happens, but the point still stands. The exhaust gas exiting the tip is very hot and it needs to be cooled. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to smash the thumbs up button, get subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos, check out the other videos on the channel, drop a comment down below letting me know what you want to see, or if there's anything I missed on this video and you want to add some information, go ahead and drop that down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one.